I am Summit High School's principal, Sarah Lamb. On behalf of the faculty, staff, and administration of Summit High School, we'd like to welcome our families, friends, and most importantly, the class of 2020. Thank you for your support of this class and wearing your mask during our ceremony. We are honored to have you here as our guest to celebrate the accomplishments and successes of this class. Please stand and remain standing as the class of 2020 processes into their arena, the national anthem, and the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Please be seated.
On behalf of Summit High School's administration, Principal Sarah Lamb, Assistant Principals Dr. Kimberly Eaton, Dr. Jewel Mason, Dr. Milton Nettles, and myself, Greg Glass, as well as our staff, we would like to honor our distinguished guests who are here to celebrate the class of 2020. Thank you for your support and leadership in Williamson County Schools. Class of 2020, tonight we are honored to have the Superintendent of Williamson County Schools, Jason Golden, and school board members, Mr. Elliot Mitchell. At this time, I would like to introduce Assistant Principal Dr. Milton Nettles for the recognition of military service.
We would like to honor all those who are currently serving, those who have served, or those who will be serving in the United States military. Class of 2020 graduates, if you are joining the U.S. military after graduation, please stand and remain standing. You may be seated. If we have any of our guests who are joining us tonight who are currently serving in the military, would you please stand and remain standing? You may be seated. And lastly, if there are any guests who have served in the United States military, any of our retired veterans, if you would, please stand and remain standing. You may be seated. Thank you all for your invaluable service to this country. And at this time, I would like to introduce Assistant Principal Dr. Kimberly Eaton to introduce our keynote speaker.
Keynote speaker for the class of 2020 is funny, a great storyteller, an expert in his field, and a constant voice of inspiration for graduating seniors at Summit High School. With a career characterized by high expectations for himself and his students, expertise in instruction, leadership, and building strong connections with students and families, his unique motivational style continues to be a catalyst for Summit success at Summit High School. It is my honor to introduce to you the class of 2020 elected keynote speaker, Mr. Russ Turpin.
Good evening. Thank you, class of 2020, for selecting me to come up here and say some words as we finally get to celebrate your graduation from Summit High School and you get to prepare for the lives that await you. Y'all, these are strange times in the midst of a worldwide pandemic that significantly changed how many of us operate. I don't know about you, but I've had a lot of time. I know you have because I've seen the TikToks. all million of them. And there is that whole full-scale model of Summit in Minecraft I also saw. And I think it even had my thermostat in it. At any rate, lots and lots of time to find new ways to avoid sleeping, which you get real creative, to watch all of Netflix, I know you did too, Tiger King, saw it twice, to walk a lot. On these walks, my mind tends to wander. I know that if you've had me in class, that's shocking that my mind would wander. But given the unusual nature of these times we're in, I've spent a whole lot of time thinking about education, about teaching from a distance, and how much I miss being able to interact with you all every day. And one thing this quarantine has definitely taught me or reiterated is the importance of what we get to do in the classroom. The teaching and the learning are important, absolutely. I gotta say that, my bosses are there. But also important are those relationships that we forge. My favorite part of this job, besides the money and the fame, right, is that when our paths converge and we get to walk a little bit together with you for a time, we're able to exchange invaluable lessons. And usually you end up teaching us much more than we could ever hope to teach you. So today I thought I would begin by reminding us of some of those lessons that you have taught me. I probably wouldn't make it out of the parking lot if I did not start with the importance of the pink plastic flamingo. Yeah, you knew that was coming. Next, the strength of a femur as it pertains to derailing a locomotive. Mind you, I teach AP language, but we had a whole physics lesson that day. Lessons about productivity from that group who called themselves the, quote, fidget winners. I don't know if they're here or not, but I did find your fidget spinner poster. It'll be hanging up on the wall at some point. Lessons about character analysis and author's purpose from Gatsby's famous train. I need to thank you all for that, because this year continued it. We'd be remiss if we did not discuss all those lessons in the quote book. But again, all my bosses are right there, and I don't know if you graduated or not yet, so let's hold off. The lessons about always planning ahead. In particular, always bring an extra pair of clothes with you. Our visit to Auschwitz really was once-in-a-lifetime experience in more ways than one. Nothing but love. Those lessons about how to appropriately trash talk in the hall, particularly when it comes to SEC football. You know who you are, and I know you love LSU. Go Dawgs, sorry. Validation that Bon Jovi is, in fact, the greatest rock band of all time. Do not try to beat me up in the parking lot. Jaden, I hope you have my back. Tic Tacs, here's a useless fact for you today. Tic Tacs are not sugar-free. You taught me that. It ruined my keto dreams. Lessons about Taylor Swift's discography, the entire discography, like every song. I now know, thanks to some of you, the location of the Starbucks in every major European city. If you try real hard before class, I discovered one day that you could turn yourself into a gnome. That was fun. All of the experts, though, agree on this final lesson before we move on a little bit, that Tobey Maguire is the worst Spider-Man. Brennan, are you okay? Wherever you are, I hope you're all right. Then, of course, there are some lessons from your essays, such classic lessons about the merits of the Somalian government, that minions are, in fact, awesome. They are. Sorry, folks. And that I might be, as many of you suspected for a while, a witch. Those kinds of lessons make this job a lot of fun. They keep things lively in the midst of a pretty tough junior year for some of you. They make us laugh, they bring us together. But you've also taught me some much more serious lessons in our time together. Lessons about the way a whole lot of you have grappled with some really tough stuff. Maybe even stuff you went through while we were together. lessons about strength and perseverance and resilience in the face of those seemingly incredible or seemingly impossible obstacles. Strength, perseverance, and resilience that seems to be beyond your years. Lessons about finding a voice and using it confidently to convey deep, deep truths about life, about colors, about ingrown toenails of all things, about waking up in pain every day, about barns and backyards, about the true meaning of family, about friends who tragically passed too soon, about mental health, about vans your grandparents gave you, or walks with your grandmother, or remembrances of your grandfather. And through all of that, lessons about vulnerability, and that it is okay to cry tears of joy, relief, and pride in the back of a classroom while your kids read their exit essays. The importance of those conversations beyond trash talk about SEC football. Sitting in windowsills at the end of the upper B hallway, sitting in the room at lunch, after school, or in coffee shops or buses throughout Central Europe. The importance of listening to each other, of hearing each other, of caring, really caring about one another. You also taught me, though, or maybe reminded is a better word here, that being comfortable is an enemy of progress. Complacency breeds mediocrity and stagnation. When we are comfortable and complacent, we need folks to nudge us out of that comfort zone a little, because that's where growth and progress and maybe even transformation can occur. And really, all of that growth, progress, transformation comes down to a choice we make every single day. I'm reminded of Lee in East of Eden and his search for the true meaning of the word Timshel, a Hebrew word that he had encountered in the book of Genesis that had left him confused about the true intent, the true message of the story. He finds, after a 10-year search for the meaning of one word, the Timshel can be translated into two little words, thou mayest. This discovery marks an epiphany for Lee, because thou mayest indicates a choice, that you may do something. And inherent in that choice is power, the power to choose our own destinies, to choose our own paths in life, the power then to create our own stories, our own mythologies, our own legends, the power to save ourselves, maybe, from ourselves. Or as Lee says, that makes a man great. That gives him the stature of the gods, for in his weakness and his filth and his murder of his brother, he still has a great choice. He can choose his course and fight it through and win. It's this notion of choice and the power that comes along with it that I hope you'll carry you out into the world. You see, today marks the end of one part of your journey. High school's over. You have completed it. You have chosen your course. You have fought it through. And despite a global pandemic and a mountain of other challenges, you have won, as evidenced by the diploma that you're about to receive. Another path now awaits you. But which path? That's up to you. I know this, though. If you look over the path that you've made these past few years, it's obvious you have left your mark. Your impact at Summit High School won't be soon forgotten, as your metrics, your GPAs, your ACT scores, the colleges you're attending, the scholarship money you've received, all speak for themselves. And your impact on me won't be soon forgotten either, as evidenced by a shirt with an epilepsy fighting unicorn on it, another shirt that says Kid Rock for Mayor, a rocking chair that now sits on my front porch so that I could use it these past few months, a Keurig that sits behind my desk, all physical reminders of just how important relationships are, just how important it is to push ourselves out of our comfort zones, just how important you are for the impact you had on this allegedly balding, it's fine, middle-aged English teacher. Now it's time to think about what kind of impact you want to have in the world. What kind of legacy will you leave? What kind of path will you forge? Because what you do from here on out is completely up to you. You have and will have for the remainder of your lives important choices to make. Some will work out well. Some will likely end up being miserable failures. Some will fall somewhere in the middle, and that's okay. That's life. I just urge you that no matter what, do not discount yourselves. Do not discount your potential to impact other people or their potential to impact you. Do not discount your strength, your perseverance, your resilience. I'd like to leave you with these words from Lee, which captures one of the most important lessons you taught me in our time together. Lee says, "I have a new love for that glittering instrument, the human soul. It is a lovely and unique thing in the universe. It is always attacked and never destroyed because thou mayest." This is where the shared portion of our journey ends. Make a choice to go build the life you want. Make a choice to go build a life that you love. You have that power, you have that potential, and you are enough. In fact, you are just what this world needs right now. Congratulations, class of 2020. I'm proud of you. Dream big, and good luck. It is now my honor to introduce Cami Kinzer, senior class president.
The class of 2020 would like to introduce Michaela Fantine, Summit High School's salutatorian.
Hello, my name is Michaela Fantine, and I am honored to speak as a salutatorian of the Summit High School class of 2020. I want to thank the teachers, administration, parents, as well as all the important people in our lives that has helped us grow into the young adults we are today. I want to thank Mr. Cherry and Ms. McNeely for taking a personal interest in my future. You pushed me to see my potential when I didn't believe in myself. I also want to thank my parents, family, and friends that have supported me throughout my high school journey. Your love helped me hope during the difficult times and encouraged me to be my best self. And now to my classmates. We made it. Not the way that we expected, but after today, we take the next step to become independent and capable adults, ready to take on the world. We know that we are ready to focus on our future, but it can be difficult to look forward without the closure that most senior classes receive. Due to the coronavirus pandemic, we have lost most of the laughs that make our senior experience truly special. We had to sacrifice our senior prom, our senior prank, our senior skip day, the last musical, the senior seasons of our spring sports, time with our friends, and a last day of school that we know to cherish and say our goodbyes. But we still have so many memories to fill in the gaps. For example, we went to football for state for the first time this year. Junior year, volleyball beat Paige in the district tournament in a huge upset. There were multiple marching band competitions. During our years, we beat Indy in football for the first time. There were many school musicals. Phil the Pineapple was a staple of our student section. Powderpuff became a celebration of our year every single year. And this year, we finally won the homecoming float decorating contest. There are many more, too many to count, too many to name. But now, we must realize that this is only the end of the beginning of our lives. For some of us, we continue on to college, others to technical school, the military, or the workforce. Whatever path we choose, it will lead us on the greatest adventure, life. Let us come out of this challenging time stronger and ready to face anything thrown at us. As Neil Gaiman said, the old rules are crumbling and nobody knows what the new rules are. So make up your own rules. My fellow graduates, now is the time that we choose to move forward or make our mark on the world. Congratulations. At this time, I would like to introduce Ellie Driver, Student Body Vice President.
At this time, I would like to introduce Cole Gershkovich, Summit High School Salutatorian.
These are dark times. But here we are sharing one bright moment together. I'd like to tell you about one of the brightest moments I have ever experienced, hidden within the single darkest day of my life. On the evening of July 18th, 2019, exactly 1 year ago, I tried to take my life. I remember police and EMTs trying to get the story out of me. But my throat just wouldn't let my voice come out. And my head was caught up in that grotesque collision between reality and nightmare. A few minutes later, one of my friends rushed over. He knelt with me on the grass, and he asked me careful questions and listened to my answers. I had the strength to stand up and to let them lead me into the ambulance. And then one of the EMTs asked my friend if he was going to come to the emergency room with us. And that was that moment. Because my friend, sitting just a few feet away, couldn't even register what they had asked him. It took him a couple seconds for him to say, "Yeah, I'm gonna go with him," like it was the silliest question in the world. And I understood. I understood what the poets talk about, the painters, the old songs, the new songs, all the naive dreamers, the Disney movies. Everyone who says that it all goes back to love. We get to have these dark days, and we get to have these bright loves. We get to be that bright love for each other, for ourselves. We get to be it in our grocery stores and across the street, in our protests, in our rallies, in our showers, through the sleepless nights, in the places that don't quite feel like home, our hospitals, our schools, and in the moments that just feel like in-betweens. I am very fortunate to be here today, to be here at all, and I have so many people to thank for that. But I won't list them because not even I like my voice that much. But I will say, I recognize that not everybody is so fortunate. My heart goes out to those people who have lost their loved ones to the darkness within them. In particular, I want the Spicer family to know that while I did not personally know Lee, I feel with them in the pain of her absence. And I promise to continue to help the people who suffer from the problems that people do not want to talk about. Our world has many different causes that all require complete dedication. Mental health advocacy is only one of those such causes. But what I have learned in my short life so far, something that I believe all of us can put into action, is that everybody is carrying around something. It's not mental illness for everybody, but as an old friend of mine says, everyone is carrying around their sack of rocks. Everyone is carrying around an opportunity for you to love them, and that includes yourself. I don't know if my friend remembers that moment in the ambulance. We've never talked about it since then. Maybe he doubts the impact of his love. But we must always believe in our ability to care for each other and to care for ourselves. Just as the stars must bemoan the fact that there are light years and light years of darkness between them, we often wonder if anyone even cares if we shine. But I promise you, people do care. From here, we're going to separate. We're going to go and follow our own paths. But I want you to know that I wish for you not just the happy days, but also the good ones. I wish for you that sense of finally coming home, of falling in love with what makes you want to get out of bed in the morning. Those things, those purposes that make fighting through the darkness worth it. Wherever you go, I hope, finally, that through all of it, you feel that you really are worth that starlight. I would now like to introduce Marley Connor, student body president for the 2019-2020 school year.
The class of 2020 would like to introduce Summit High School's valedictorian, Noah Bell.
Greetings, faculty, administration, family, friends, and the Summit High class of 2020. You know, these really are unprecedented times. I mean, who could have guessed that a bat thousands of miles away would end up sealing half of our senior year? But regardless of these circumstances, we've all been left with many memories from these past 4 years to cherish. I remember, and I'm sure you all do as well, when we were a mewling, clueless freshman, stumbling through foreign hallways, not yet plastered with the familiar "no course changes after May 24th posters. We were naive, frightened creatures, profoundly disturbed by Mr. Gilbert's pinky finger. And yet, over time, we slowly started to grasp the essence of what it meant to be educated, engaged, and nurtured through meaningful experiences, positive relationships, and character development. What it meant to come out of Plato's cave and see the sunlight, or to realize that a loaded baked potato isn't still a potato. The fact is, we learned a few very important quasi-essential things at this institution. I can even count them out on my fingers, which I will. One, some of us are magicians capable of making paper towel rolls, soap dispensers, and even entire toilets disappear. Two, it is possible to whistle the Star Wars soundtrack nearly every day without tiring of it. Three, a pineapple makes for a more fearsome mascot than the most brutal ancient Grecian warrior. Four, some thermostats are never to be touched. Five, and finally, This place has been our home for the past 4 years. And it's also a place that we'll probably miss one day, even if we don't realize that now. Typically, in these kinds of speeches, there is a message that comes across the lines of, we made memories here that will last us a lifetime. But that's not really true, is it? Memory is such a fickle, imperfect thing. It is stubborn and weak and inconsistent and sometimes tragic. I know there are some people in our graduating class who won't be here to walk across the stage, whether that be virtually or in July. Humans, both fortunately and unfortunately, are designed in such a way that we sometimes forget and move on. But that doesn't mean it was all pointless, that the precious moments we spent in the youth of our lives are destined to fade away into obscurity. Because really, all the time we spent here has become the catalyst for a series of personal reinventions. We have been transformed and altered in minute and infinitely immense ways. We have grown in maturity and intelligence as standard bearers for the wisdom our mentors and parents have imparted upon us. We fulfilled Summit's own raison d'etre, grasping towards a future that is bright and filled with hope. And it's because of these past 4 years that the Summit Class of 2020 will doubtless go on to do great things. Now, don't let me mislead you. It won't be easy. The world is big and scary. And as adults, we will initially be fogbound with no compass, adrift in a sea with red skies. But even if our memories slowly ebb away, the individual changes we encountered within them won't. They'll journey with us into our tumultuous, uncertain futures, through raging tempests and across unfamiliar settings. And ultimately, the entire rest of our lives are predicated upon them. Trust me when I say these diplomas you are receiving have been well earned and will be the hallmark of new, promising beginnings. So congratulations, and good luck to you all. The Summit High Class of 2020.
Summa cum laude is the highest academic recognition award to students with a cumulative GPA of 4.25 or higher. The class of 2020 who earned the honor of summa cum laude, please stand and remain standing as your name is called. Brennan Angus, Mia Apple, Noah Bell, Madison Berg, Molly Bowman, Aiden Broom, Kobe Bull, Amanda Butler, Lucas Buttry, William Chin, Haley Craig, Aubrey Crawford, Hannah Curtis, Ellie Driver, Michaela Fantine, Claire Gamlin, Cole Gershkovich, Elias Gerstein, Cullen Goliath, Amelia Greathouse, Carlin Harrelson, Tara Jones, Elizabeth Lewis, Calvert Lindberg, Joseph Lukens, Mia Martinez, Yulia Melanchenko, Briley Nash, Alexis Nelson, Rushi Patel, Taylor Penning, Abby Sartori, Christina Sheets, Aaron Seaman, Camden Sloan, Holly Smith, Andrew Stiverson, Jaden Taddeo, Kaylin Thomas, William Toll, Elizabeth Vinson, Mae Wallace, Meredith Warren, Julia Weinstein, Anna White, Emily Wilhelm.
To Tonight, you'll notice that our graduates and faculty are wearing a teal ribbon in memory of Lee Spicer. Summit High School's class of 2020 was given the opportunity to choose two faculty members to read their names as they walk across the stage tonight. Please help me in honoring Mr. Jacob Burkett and Mrs. Jenny Parkhurst as they present the diplomas to the class of 2020.
Please remember, we have 300 graduates' names to call. Please be respectful and hold your applause till the end so each family can hear their students' names being called.
Michaela Marie Fantine. Cole Benjamin Gershkovich. Hayden Christopher Aldridge. Jackson Cord Allen. DeAndre Lee Anderson. Mia Apple. Jacob Thomas Armbrust. Kisten Malik Arnold. Jimena Valentina Ayala.
Ashton Michelle Bahan. Chandler Bahan. Evan Cade Baggett. Reese Kane Bailey. Rachel Elizabeth Baldwin. David Joseph Bell. Robert Hayden Bell. Caitlin Nicole Bennett. Jordan Elaine Bond. William Edwin Bond. Benjamin Reed Bonson. Molly Grayling Bowman. David Wayne Boyd. Jaden Janelle Brackens. Kylie Lynn Brady. Tyler James Brando. Chinoa Kaya Ione Briggs. Aiden Patrick Broom. Courtney Nicole Brown. Robert Coleman Brown. Nathan Morris Buckley. Kyle Roberto Bueno. Colby Charles Bull. Faith Aaron Burnett. Amanda Grace Butler. Lucas Garner Buttry.
Camila Alexandra Cabrera. Colton Wayne Capley. Anna Jean Carden. Demontre Major Carlton. Joseph James Carollo. Ephron LeBronze Carter. John Ronan Casey. Larissa Janae Cawthon. Brianna Chavez Reyes. William Menloon Chen. Corinne Grace Cherry. Ethan Bradley Chilton. Austin Charles Clark. Jordan Robert Clunan. Gina Lynn Collins. Marley Drew Connor. Emily Lauren Cook. Julian Christopher Cordell. Mariah Joy Kaur. Haley Ariana Craig. Aubrey Grace Crawford. Mary Catherine Cullen. Kyla Noel Culver. Haley Dawn Curtis. Hannah Joe Curtis.
Austin Ray Daly. Jacob Elijah Darnell. Olivia Catherine Darty. Kelsey Alexandria Davis. Corbin Julius Dawson. David Allen Dayer. Laura Janet De La Vega. Allison Marie DeChesky. Carrie Dale DeHart. Elisa Michelle Demarest. Connor James DeSell. Alexander Ward Dixon. Brianna Marie DiPaolo. Nathan David Doziak. Helen Elizabeth Driver. Olivia Grace Durer.
Megan Elizabeth Easterday. Caleb Daniel Edens. Cameron Gage Edwards. Raina Nicole Irwin. Brittany Cecilia Lynn Evans. Reese Michael Ferrero. Tyler James Farmer. John Liam Ferris. Ian Isaiah Fernandez. Braden Cole Fitzgerald. Cassidy Kathleen Flatt. Colby Ryan Fletcher. Brandon David Fox. Aaron Michael Franklin. Alexandra Juliet France.
Tylee Harrison Gehring. Claire Marie Gamlin. Jordan Quinn Garcia. Liam Brecken Garner. Josiah Seth Geisen. Jacob Patrick Geitman. Elias James Gerstein. Jack Durden Glenn. Maximiliano Gonzalez Martinez. Javer Ali Gonzalez Rios. Gabby Lane Goodwin. Miles Anthony Grady. Matthew Lane Gray. Alexander Scott Griffin. Brenda Gutierrez.
Lucy Grace Hall. Cade Edward Hansen. Bobby Zeta Harris. Jack Thomas Hazelrig. Colton Michael Hendricks. Ashlyn Elizabeth Henley. Christopher Kasten Hensel. Jillian Grace Herring. Jalen Robert Herod. Kaylin Allen Hewitt. Grayson Eric Hill. Brock Alexander Holforty. Stacy Aaron Holt. Kelly Elizabeth Hooper. Jesse Rivers Hule. Julian Isaac Houston. Matthew Allen Hudgens. Garrett Cole Huffstetler. Hayden Blaine Humphrey. Anna Darlene Hunt. Haley Joe Hutchison.
Caleb Edward Jackson. Kennedy Shea Jaros. Brendan Reed Joffs. Garrett Franklin Johnson. Gabriel Scott Kading. John Tanner Kamunin. Bailey Ashton Kelly. Clara Jean Kendall. Angel Elizabeth Kennedy. Timothy Cole Kennedy. Cameron Elise Kinzer. Mackenzie Marie Kirby. Daniel Dimitri Kirkland. Trey Anthony Jerome Knox. Ashley Taylor Kohler. Megan Ann Kapitsky. Ryan Patrick Kroll. Justin Thomas Cooter.
Haley Dolores Lacoste. Brian Ladrone De Guevara. Addison Anna Elizabeth Landers. Ashton Steele LaBelle. William Ryan Lesko. Elizabeth Joy Lewis. Blake Alexander LaSierra. Calvert James Lindberg. Peyton Lily Lindley. Arabella Grace Linger. Alyssa Marie Loy. Joseph Edmund Lukens.
James David Maddox. Kaylee Renee Magi. Mia Jasmine Martinez. Leroysha Tatiana Alicia Mayberry. Andrew Robert McCall. Aaliyah Natalia McDaniel. Alexandria Miles McTavish. Mallory Lane Meeks. Kelly Danielle Maherg. Yulia Vasilyevna Melanchenko. Zachary James Millage. Tyler Thomas Miller. Allison May Mollis. Blake Benjamin Money. Carson Presley Moody. Gerardo Daniel Mota. Andrew Jacob Munger. Aubrey Danielle Murphy. Eleni Marie Nader. Briley Ann Nash. Christian Dean Nelson. Jacob Matthew Oliasani.
Stephen Earl Pardo III. Ethan Allen Pargman. Gabrielle Claire Park. Kaylee Brianna Payne. Bailey Savannah P. Sarah Grace Petchy. Taylor Grace Penning. Alora Mae Perkins. Jessica Maya Peterson. Owen Weber Peterson. Mallory Danielle Pewitt. Andrew Christopher Pierce. Robert Harry Plummer IV. Hannah Elizabeth Pollard. Alexis Denise Prather. Brock Cameron Preston. Jonathan Nathaniel Prophet. Ryan Richard Province.
Vivianne Quatch. Morgan Isabella Rakotsi. Ethan Alexander Ramirez. Caitlin Nicole Reeves. Rady Reichard. Austin Shay Rennie. Henry Scott Richardson. Haley Christine Roach. Trinity Akaya Deborah Robertson. Amani Andrea Robinson. Connor Clay Robinson. Megan Elizabeth Robinson. Juliana Alicia Rodriguez. Riley McKay Rollison. Merrill Evan Ruhlman. Colin Wayne Rummage. Wesley Andrew Rummage.
Sarah Abigail Salmon. Vanessa Sanchez. Abby Lynn Sartori. Shaylin Nicole Sawyers. Chase Allen Schmidlin. Barbara Cheyenne Scott. Carly Allison Scott. Kendra Elizabeth Scott. McGuire Gavin Scruggs. Isabella Anna Sepulveda. Nicholas J. Scarlatta. Lior Israel Shakar.
William Race Shake. Christina Marie Sheets. Stephanie Nicole Short. Aaron Rebecca Seaman. Camden Edward Sloan. Cameron Lane Smiley. Autumn Ray Smith. Holly Nicole Smith. Blake Allen Swallow. Colby Brett Stallings. Caleb Seth Stanley.
Sydney Rose Stats. Robert Michael Stevenhagen. Parker Caroline Stewart. Andrew Lee Stiverson. Aiden Ernest Stewart. Jaden Michael Taddeo. Angelo Nash Terabay. Emma Grace Thomas. Colton Lee Thomason. Lennon Raphael Torres. Mackenzie Lynn Trumbo.
Justin Thomas Turner. Anastasia Rianne Tyndall. Lydia Francisca Ubira. Chaz Parker Vance. Noah Patrick Van Fleet. Billy Javier Vega. Shauna Ray Beltry. Marissa Cyan Vincent. Elizabeth Danielle Vinson.
Gregory Arthur Walker. Kai Taylor Ward. Meredith Avery Warren. Carson Daniel Watkins. Aaron Tyler Way. Julia Ann Weinstein. Hayden Edward Winzicki. Anna Brooke White. Jack Thomas Wiggins. Emily Ann Wilhelm. Abby Janice Wilson. Madeline Paige Wallenhop. Grant Patterson Woosley. At this time, I would like to introduce Joyce Hollins, our lead counselor.
The class of 2020 have been offered 13,652,559 in scholarships as of today. We applaud them for their amazing accomplishments at Summit High School. We applaud them for their amazing accomplishments at Summit High School and look forward to hearing of their success and their post-secondary plans.
Graduates and guests, if you'll please stand for the singing of the Alma Mater by Summit High School's choir, and the words can be found on the back of your program. Graduates, remain standing. By the authority vested in me by the governor of the great state of Tennessee, the Honorable Bill Lee, Tennessee's Commissioner of Education, Dr. Penny Schwinn, Williamson County School Board Chairman, Gary Anderson, and the Superintendent of Williamson County Schools, Jason Golden, I confer the appropriate diplomas for the class of 2020. Graduates, if you will please move your tassel to the left. Congratulations, class of 2020. Graduates, if you will please recess out. Thank you all for coming. We hope you have a safe drive home.